we're taking down Christmas, our Christmas tree, as we are at the end of the holiday. And we have a lot to celebrate this holiday season. This is a new video for the newest addition to our family, coming June 2014.
You'll be with us next year, little baby. And Maddie can show you how to put the ornaments on the tree. Right, Matt?
Matthew, what's going on in Mommy's belly?
To get down. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock the microphone because I get stupid. I mean outrageous. Stay away from me if you're contagious, because I'm a winner. Don't not a loser. To be an MC is what I choose. Ladies love me. Girls adore me. I mean, even the ones who never saw me, like the way that I rhyme at a show. The reason why, man, I don't know. So let's go, because...
There's a baby, a girl or a boy in Mommy's belly, Matt?
I think there's a boy.
Oh, there you have it.
There you go.
Now, if it happens to be a girl, we'll edit in girl. So we need him to say girl. Matthew, say girl.
Girl.
There it is. We'll be able to edit it right in. Sarah's driving, and maybe I'll drive home and we'll try it. Start to make the footage that'll make the video that'll be the culmination of the pregnancy, which is June 9th, 2014, baby number two. And we are at this point, last video, the interview was basically Sarah in a bed with Roxy and in a, like this dark lighting, and it was a terrible, this time we're going for video quality. So, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling much better now.
It was a rough patch.
It was a rough start, little baby. But, you know, pretty much from like 5 to 6 weeks until almost 17 weeks, I was very, very sick, nauseous and vomiting and all kinds of craziness.
All the good stuff.
But right after Christmas, around, I think it was 17, I started to... be okay around food again and be able to eat more things and feel much better. So we're doing good now. Thank goodness.
We've leaped the hurdle.
Yeah.
We've crossed the threshold. And now we're cruising. And this, we decided this year not to go on a cruise.
No cruising.
Even though you were pretty much just as sick as if you were on a cruise.
I was. Might as well have been on a cruise.
Right. So Matthew was just about getting ready to turn three when we found out we were having another baby. You want to talk about
September 2013? We found out that we were pregnant and having another baby, and we're very excited about that. 9 miles. Keep left. And then pretty much a couple weeks after that, it all went downhill because I started getting very sick. Still excited, but it was hard to really focus on it because I was just trying to focus on staying alive.
And we're gonna wait till about what, 10 to 12 weeks before we even started telling anybody. But because you were sort of not feeling your best, we decided that maybe it would be a good idea to let people know, our close family.
Well, we told Grammy and Puppy and Grandma and Grandpa around 8 weeks.
Yeah, we had an ultrasound. We had a couple early ultrasounds.
And everything is good. A strong heartbeat.
We got the...
A fast heartbeat.
And that's good, right?
That's a good thing. Some people say the faster it is, the more they think it's a girl. But who knows? Because you were fast and you could be a boy. So that's fine, too.
Yes. Do you have a fast heartbeat? Because I know my pulse is so slow. The doctor told me that I was a marathon runner.
Yes.
I've never run a marathon, but...
Or a half marathon.
But if I did, I certainly would have the pulse for it.
That's correct.
Doctor this time.
We switched doctors. Dr. Wagner is our doctor. And everything is good, you know.
We don't want to implicate anyone by saying why we switched. But right. It might have had something to do with Matthew breaking mommy's pelvis.
Possibility.
And potentially some disregard to that. So we're going for Rat Wagner. It was the same doctor that delivered Joshua.
And Corinne.
No, I don't think Corinne was Wagner.
I think she was.
All right, here's the first wager of the night. I am saying that Dr. Wagner delivered Joshua. There's a whole story that goes along with that. But I don't think he delivered Corinne.
And I think he delivered both your cousins.
All right.
Matthew had some young girl deliver him.
Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna get Joanna on the line. What are the chances that she'll pick up? But if she picks up, we'll get to the bottom of this. And I was like, baby, 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 oh,
like, baby, baby, baby. So here we are in Matthew's big boy room with Mark. And Roxy.
Now this is the, everyone who saw the first video, this was like their favorite part. All seven people who saw it thought like this is the best part where we sat with Roxy and we talked about the names. Because everybody always likes to talk about names. And we're starting with the girl, just like we did last time.
Okay.
So, this was not easy. This was not an easy one. We felt like Matthew, we just kind of knew. So we think our leading name is Eva, E-V-A, and we're not sure still with the middle name. We actually like the middle name Felice, which is Grandma Sheila's middle name, and we also like Elizabeth, which is Mommy's middle name, but we're not sure how we're gonna, we think we like Eve Elizabeth, or possibly Eva Felice, but guess what? It's still to be decided. What
true.
Do you think?
I guess time will tell, right? What other names did you like for a girl?
Well, for about 5 minutes or so, we thought we might do Juliet.
Yes. Then we got over that.
Yeah. And if Matthew was a girl, she probably would have been Demi.
Yes, then we got over that.
I think the second we got rid of it, people started to like it. So... Crazy.
You liked Camilla.
Oh, yeah. I loved Camilla. I liked Camilla.
Camilla.
I was afraid they would call her Camilla.
Like, so we crossed that off.
Yes. And any other names that we liked?
I don't know. We were pretty...
You said on some sort of variation of Eve, right? You want to call her...
Evie.
Evie. And I think that if it's Eva or Eve or Evie... You can probably interchange the names anyway.
True.
Because Matthew, we call Maddie. Sometimes we call him Maddie Moo. For a while there, we called him Junie. And he was never worse for wear. Oh, and Matthew said that if we have a girl, he wants the name to be Princess Presto.
From Super Y.
Yes, that's like the little African-American Super Y princess. So who knows what'll happen. All right. Roxy, anything else to add?
She's licking your arm. Okay, we're back after the sonogram. There you are, little baby. One, two, three, hold on, four, there's your, I believe that's your arm bones, there is your big monster foot, and that is a hand you're waving to us.
All right, well, that was a pretty painless process. That was all right. It was like 25 minutes in and out. I remember our prior 20-week sonogram, 3 years ago now, took a lot longer, right?
I think that's correct.
It did. It took a lot longer. I don't think we went in there for about an hour and a half.
But she said, without saying too much, she said everything looks good. She'll send the report to Dr. Wagner.
She made it clear that the baby does, in fact, have a gender.
We asked her not to tell us, which she didn't even hint at it, and based on that, I really have no clue what it is, what you are, baby.
It's either going to be a boy or a girl.
That's correct.
I think that's important in and of itself, right?
That's true, but I thought we weren't even going to ask her. Could you tell?
And then I did it.
I know, but last time you told me not to ask that, because last time you felt like they gave it away.
Last time they did give it away.
So
last time that she might as well have just went boy to boy to boy 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 boy.
But we saw your heart beating, we saw all the ventricles of your brain, we saw all your bones, your feet, both hands, we saw your ears, your eyes, your upper lip. Hopefully you have a bottom lip.
Your thigh bone.
And everything seems to be good. 19 weeks to go till we get to meet you and bring you home, and you have an awesome big brother waiting for you. And a big sister, Roxy Dukes Siegel. She's going to love you to pieces. And we're all going to love you to pieces. Right, Dad?
Yes, figuratively pieces. Not literally.
Correct.
Got
Talk
it.
To you later. Signing off.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We're now in the baby nursery. Still kind of mostly set up for Matthew, even though Matthew's been in his big boy room for several weeks. And we are kind of changing over to this, back to nursery. How are you feeling?
I'm doing all right.
Yeah?
A little bit tired from all the up and down, getting on and off the floor, playing with Matthew, but overall, I shouldn't complain.
So basically what we've been doing today has been kind of a lazy day. We've been sorting through some clothes.
We finished sorting through all the girls' clothes that Mike and Nicole Halley gave us because they're having their third boy. So we're all organized if you're a girl,
yes.
Or if you're a boy, because we have Matthew's clothes all ready to go for you.
Before we had Matthew, we went to Lamaze class. Remember this?
Mm-hmm.
So it took me a long time, but I finally found the notes we had from Lamaze class.
Okay.
So I thought maybe, like a game show, I can try to quiz you on some of the, facts, things we learned back then, and see how much you remember.
Okay.
So, maybe I can turn on some of our favorite game show music, like, I don't know, The Price is Right,
yeah.
Or The Pyramid, and, okay, here we go. Question number one. We won't do too many. What percentage of women do their water break on its own? We're looking for a percentage.
15%.
15%? That's correct.
Really?
Yes. Wow.
I was listening.
That's pretty good. So, are you ready for question two?
I'm ready.
What percentage of moms get epidurals?
70%?
Close.
75?
Correct. That's pretty good.
Thanks.
All right, I have a word. This is a question. I don't know if you're going to be able to answer this.
Okay.
Corvad. C-O-R-E-V-A-D.
Yeah.
Well, define that.
Banking?
Apparently that's the men's symptom of pregnancy. Whether it be stomach or abdominal pain or cravings.
Did you have that?
I think I've always had that. I'm hungry right now. But you want to hear something interesting I found out?
Yeah.
If you have a C-section, do you know what I get to wear?
Everything.
That's not what it says here. It says the dad gets to wear a white jumpsuit.
Right, because everything's going to be covered.
There's nothing wrong about that.
I don't say there's anything wrong with a jumpsuit.
Like an Elvis?
It's not like an Elvis jumpsuit, it's like a hospital jumpsuit.
What's a hospital jumpsuit?
It protects any germs. You have to wash your hands for like 30 seconds up to here.
Is it a one piece?
It's a sterile environment. You can't bring any germs in or else you can infect me. So I'm 28 weeks now, and I think overall I just feel very round. So I think my gut is telling me that you're going to be another big baby, just like your brother Matthew, who is 10 pounds, 2 ounces.
And big is healthy.
And big is healthy. I don't say anything wrong with it, but I just feel like I think I grow big babies because I feel very round. Unless it's just me that's round and not you, baby, but... we shall see. 12 more weeks to go.
All of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges. All your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me. I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me. And you give me all of you.
Roxy's still hugging the camera.
It's time for baby boy names.
And I think it's a boy, so these could be come into serious contention.
Yes. We have, okay, so our front runner is Sean.
Sean Siegel.
Sean's not bad.
I hope not.
Sean Siegel. Because it's two different sounds. Shh and S.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're likely going to go with Sean if it's a boy, unless we can think of anything better between now and then. But middle name?
Well, most likely I think we're leaning towards my dad's name, which is?
Sean Peter Siegel, SPS.
Yes, SPS.
And, you know, we really don't have any runner-ups for Sean. We had a whole bunch. I mean, there are still the names we like. We like Andrew. We like Adam, but really, at this point, it's probably going to be Sean.
We liked Anthony for middle name, for puppy.
And
I liked Colin, you don't.
That's your puppy.
For Sassy's puppy.
We also like, Pete's middle name is Robertson, which we kind of like too.
Right.
So there'd be some, probably some, if it's a boy, there'll probably be some sort of, name connection with Pete.
True.
If Matthew has his way and it's a boy, he wants to name him Batman.
Batman!
Nice. So we'll see. We don't know. It doesn't matter to us. We're going to be happy no matter what. But if it's a boy, you heard it here first. Sean.
Peter.
Siegel.
Signing off.
All right.
Okay, we're at Callahan Beach. It is Memorial Day weekend. We are at the Nitty Gritty. This is our, I think, going to be our last interview before baby comes. And Matthew is here. Hey, Maddie.
Cheese.
No cheese. It's video. How are you having fun?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Playing with my toys with them.
Oh, with them? With the two little girls?
Yes.
Pretty cool. See you later. Have fun.
Au revoir.
Au revoir. Well, Matthew's having a good time at the beach, and this is the last time we're going to chat. You're, what, about a couple weeks out, a little less than 2 weeks out. So what are we up to these last couple of days?
Well, we've just been trying to get the room organized, get our house organized, get everybody as ready as possible.
We had a nice little Mother's Day, you know, barbecue. We got a brand new playground for our backyard.
We got Matthew a new playground to play with, and had a nice visit from Aunt Laura and Uncle Jason.
Tomorrow we are going to a gender reveal party. Our friends Adam and Jackie are having a baby later this year.
Yep.
And actually right about, you know, around this weekend, our good friends Dave and Allison Cooper are due, and Mike and Nicole are having their third.
Yeah.
So it's an exciting time. And
So we're getting excited.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how has this pregnancy been?
1 to 10? Well, except for the first 17 weeks, which were not that good. And probably the last few days, I've been waking up a couple times with heartburn.
It's a 10. All right, we will see you. This is it. So stay tuned. It's all happening very, very, very soon.
Signing off.
All right. Au revoir, as Matthew
revoir
would say. All right. We finally got Joanna calling in. Hold on a second. Joanna. Hello?
Hi.
Hey. Okay, listen up. You're being recorded right now. So this is for Matthew's new baby's video, okay? We have a bet here. Sarah and I have a bet. And you're going to help answer the bet.
Okay.
Okay, here's what happened. Sarah maintains that... Are you listening?
Sarah what?
Sarah says that Dr. Wagner delivered both of your children. I say he only delivered Joshua. Someone else delivered Corinne. So now you can tell us who's right.
What is the... who wins? What's the winner get?
The winner get... This is all for bragging rights.
Okay, well then, Mark is
Corinne.
What?
Of
course. Dr. Wagner did not deliver Corinne.
Who delivered Dr. Corinne?
Singer. Dr. Singer, who's no longer with the group.
Shucks. Well, I knew it wasn't Dr. Goldman, so I think I win something.
Dr. Goldman is my doctor, but he didn't deliver any records.
All right.
Mark is correct.
All right, that's
darn
what
it.
I thought. Okay, that's all we needed.
Okay, talk to you later.
All right, bye, Joe.
Bye.
All right,
the truth will
go
set
ahead
you free.
Gloat. You didn't know it was Dr. Singer, though.
I've got a memory like an elephant.
An elephant?
That's right.
Mark driving to Huntington Hospital. So, how are you feeling, Dad?
Feeling very good. Didn't get a whole lot of sleep, but you know, I was thinking that when the night before Matthew was born, when I was on a lounge chair watching, I forgot what movie it was, in the hospital, I probably got less sleep than I have today. I probably got maybe four and a half hours of sleep. Last night, and I don't even know if I got 2 hours of sleep 3 years ago. So, in the great scheme of things, I'm well rested.
Good.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. Dad's wearing a bright yellow shirt to wake everybody up. Because he didn't want to wear pink if you're a boy, and he didn't want to wear blue if you're a girl. So we went with yellow.
Yeah.
And here's me. Can't wait to meet you. Love you, baby. Thank you.
can't wait for you to join our family.
All right, we are here, back in labor delivery room 4.
This is the room Matthew was born in.
And we're waiting. We're waiting for the time to go. It's been a kind of a crazy morning because we got here early and they weren't ready for us, and there are like 18 million other babies being born basically as we speak, and we thought we were going to be waiting all day, and we're going to be waiting for a little while longer, but we are at least now, you know, Sarah's got her IVs. How are you feeling?
Good.
No epidural yet, but the next step, that's the next step. There's a whole set of instructions that was just given to me. I'm a little chilly, I'm wearing short sleeves. I know this is not about me, but we are very excited. Everything, heart rate sounds good. We're hooked up to the machines. And when I say we, I use that very, very loosely. I'm fancy free. And we're gonna keep this short. You know, we're having a baby. This is gonna be a C-section, first C-section. And last, quite frankly. Anything left to say, Sarah?
No, can't wait to meet you, baby. Can't wait to introduce you to your brother.
And now, please welcome.
Say, Sean Peter Siegel.
Sean Peter Siegel.
Can you look at me and say, Sean Peter Siegel?
Sean Peter Siegel.
Look at me one more time. Say Sean Peter Siegel.
Sean Peter Siegel.
Fall out of bed and catch a fading star. Fancy, I woke up before my alarm. Rub my mind through my eyes, it's the best I can do. Before it's automatic habit of returning to you. Though a smile when it happens, almost as if it was magic, means there's a God somewhere and he's laughing. And I shuffle my slipperless toes to the kitchen, still low to the ground, but high on living. And I know it's gonna be a good day. Hello, you beautiful thing. Waking up, I stretch my body and acknowledge the mace. Must be something I did yesterday. Pour a cup of liquid gold because my engine's still cold. But any minute everything gonna change. And I know it's gonna be a good day. Hello, hello, you beautiful thing. Beautiful thing, yeah. This is what I've been waiting for.
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 A cul-de-sac, watching the bend of the earth take the black of the night from the dirt. I can see from the depths of my readjusting eyes a reflection of yeses in an ever-changing sky. But why do bad dreams linger long after I awake? I don't need no scenes of violence or pain replayed, and I feel quite foolish sometimes when I pray. But my thoughts are all I got, so I try to make them brave. And I know gonna be a good day. Hello, hello, you beautiful thing.
When we get through the store, we're gonna go see Sean, Peter, and Mommy for the first time. You're gonna meet your baby brother. You ready?
Yes!
Okay, let's. We gotta hit this button. Can you hit this button right here? Can you reach?
No.
And now they're gonna let us in, I hope.
here it comes. Here we go. And just follow me now.
Hello.
Hello, guys.
What are you up to?
Just to see Sarah Siegel.
Okay, this is the labor room.
Oh, what did I do? Oh, no.
You're gonna go out here and all the way around.
I ruined the whole video, guys.
Aww. Okay, oh, wait. What do you want to... Can you...
I know it's gonna be a good day. Hello, you beautiful thing.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road will lead you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door close, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything.
Hold this. You hold this, Maddie.
Okay.
But hold it nice and straight. Walk with me. Through this door and all the way to that bed. Go, 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 go. All the way.
Mommy.
Hi, sweetie pie. How are you? Are those for me? Maddie, are these for me?
Yeah.
They're so beautiful. Can I take them? Can you see who's in there? Come here. Come here. Climb up on the bed. Can you climb up here? What's his name?
Peter Felice Siegel.
What is it?
Peter Felice
Siegel. How about Sean Peter Siegel?
Sean Peter Siegel.
Yeah, Daddy's going to lift you up to really get a good look at him. He's sleeping a little bit in there, right?
Can I wash with Daddy?
Yes.
My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. Never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. I hope you never look back, but you never forget all the ones who loved you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. Is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you get into, I hope you know somebody.